I was conceived in the recovery position in the basement of a police station. Brought up like a ballerina's breakfast and raised on stolen donations. The doctor cried and the midwife resigned as I was born to this world. My mother swapped me for a less ugly baby and she called me the scum of the earth. Scum of the earth, the name that I was baptized as a babe. Lightning struck the steeple of the church when the priest called out my name. He threw his Bible in the sky, pulled out a pistol and shot a hole through it like a bird. And as its feathers came spiraling down to the ground, he christened me the scum of the earth. To a 75-year-long street, and I bang my head against the factory wall. There ain't nothing to do but drink. There ain't nothing to do but abuse the booze and kiss goodbye to the day. It's enough to make a bloke lose his screws, man. I just wanna get in my grave. Cause I'm just a mild-mannered social parasite by day, but after 6.5 hours on the apple sauce, an amazing transformation takes place. Superhero or a complete fucking idiot would try and pick a fight with a police. Well, she must have been a teacher at the sumo school because her pupils were absolutely fucking huge. And she must have fell from heaven because whenever she moved, she'd end up sprawled across the floor like she'd just fallen through the roof. She believed if you held a shell suit to your ear, that you could hear Merseyside. And depending on the light, she could have been anywhere between 16 and 75. The city where it always rains is looking strange of late. Where once the sky was full of clouds, now it's full of cranes. She wants to see the city skyline sunset drunk just one last time before the tombstone skyscrapers high rise and ruin the horizon. But somehow, somewhere through town, she just grinds to a halt. The smoke takes hold and she shuts down like C-3PO. And the poor Spice Girl looks like she doesn't move at all. The streets around her change so fast, now it looks like she's stood still. And the poor Spice Girl looks like she's been paused in a picture. And now every time she blinks, the world looks different. And she'll come round in some odd future that she doesn't understand. The past she knew so distant, now it may as well have never happened. Falling over in slow motion, she may as well sleep where she lies. Cause Boris told me, the homeless, they're mostly claustrophobic. They actually prefer to be outside, honestly, everything's fine. Here comes your man, the provider, the supplier, and the silver-tongued speaker of lies. He rescues you from the gutter and you shuffle through the bustle looking just like two wrestlers intertwined. He has eyes like thumb holes in dough, eyes like a fat man's belly buttons, deep and hollow. He has eyes like wormholes in time, struggling to see past the last 20 years of his life. He's got a face like one of those magic eye paintings from the 90s. It's all spots and blotches that just don't make no fucking sense. Till 4 in the morning, when you're completely off your head, and he suddenly appears to be the best friend you've ever had. Dripping with sweat, wearing nothing but a vest, jogging bottoms and a facial scar, hopping on one leg and holding a stolen roller carpet underneath his arm. He was gagging for a shite, he asked me for a light and the tinfoil off my chocolate bar. Man, the poor motherfucker, he must have been clucking like the boot of Bernard Matthews' car. Back to the flat with a mattress so tatty it looks like a sleeping bag left in the road. But it doesn't matter if the flat feels cold when the needle feels just like home. And the Daily Mail neighbours in the flats above can't understand how something so incredibly rough could be capable of falling in love. But people in crack houses shouldn't smoke rocks. Every city has a secret city hidden underneath it, but it's not the gritty underground that the tourists seek. It is that other neighbourhood, the one we dare not speak of, the one that the estate agents did not want you to see. We've just made begging illegal because they'll only spend it on smack, says the man with the golden handshake who's just bought up all the land. Yeah, drugs are bad. Oh, but I can think of something that is even more addictive than smack, and that's money. If you give a man a fish, that man will have fish for his tea. But if you teach a man to fish, he will wipe out the fucking species. And what's the difference between a diamond and a shard of broken glass when both will only leave you with blood all over your hands? Well, I had a most terrible daydream as I was propping up the end of the bar. My life fragmented into millions of jigsaw pieces and scattered all over the floor. And frantically on my hands and knees, I tried picking up the shard and piecing it back together again, but the picture looked all wrong. And I staggered back to the bar, wiping my face, but the expression on the people's faces had changed. "What's your poison?" the barman asked. I saw terrible visions in the bottom of my glass. Printed on the t-shirts to corrupt the pupils, you poison the teachers. I heard the untrustworthy word being preached by the dyad disciples of Saturday Night TV, who like to make you think life's just a rehearsal, because it helps to cope with the hurt that comes with the curse of being a person, a brand new definition of worthlessness. This blinding clarity is like a pencil in my eye. Take your dick out of my ear and stop fucking with my mind. "What's your poison?" the barman asked. I saw terrible visions in the bottom of my glass. And I screamed at the people to warn them, but they just turned back to the drinks and ignored me. And then the management asked me to leave, so now I'm outside shouting at the traffic on the street, shaking my fist at the useless moon, trying to catch the stupid thing with a lasso. Maybe I'm just confused, but I can't seem to see the world the way that I used to. Cross the road like that chicken in the joke, but your narrow mind is too small to look down on me. Class never has been a straight line, and respect is a two-way street. The land that your cattle are reared on is poisoned. The fruit your trees bear, manufactured by man. Your media and art is corrupted by money and therefore irrelevant to me and my clan. Your wealth is like time, a powerful concept which when studied closely doesn't actually exist. What will you do when the people you put down discover the foundations of your house are so weak they will split? So I'll just leave you to worry about things like reputation and worth, but just remember this planet is made out of dirt when you call me the scum of the earth.